Greetings, everyone, and welcome. My name is Wes Bunn, and I'm a technical writer here at Epic Games. And we're here today to show you how you can work with Unreal Motion Graphics, or UMG for short, to create your own inventory system. So let's take a look at the finished project here. Let me go ahead and hop in and show you what it is we're going to try and create here together over the course of this video series. So in the upper left, we have our health, energy, and mood displayed. It is also affected by gameplay, as you would expect. So as we jump around, we are losing energy. So we're going to show you how to set something like this up. So we have health, energy, and mood. We also have some items inside of our level here. These are our pickups. So if I press I, you can see that our inventory slides in from the right side of the screen. If I press I again, our inventory goes away. If we go near one of our pickups, you can see that there is text above the pickup that kind of follows us around as we go near it. And as we move away, it goes away. We can pick it up by pressing E when we are near it, and then we can press I to bring up our inventory. And there's our inventory. We can hover over it, and we can click on it. There's a bunch of different options we can do here. We can return back to the inventory menu. We can click on it. We can drop it. It removes it from our inventory, at which point we could look down, and there it is right at our feet. So I can press E to pick it back up. Hit I, and it's back in our inventory, at which point I could use it, or eat the banana in this instance, and it gave me some health and energy and mood. If I hit I again, and there's some other pickups as well, so we could pick this one up, we could pick this one up, and we can also go over here and maybe pick up this little bush here and collect firewood, so we could press E to pick that up. We press I, and all those things have been added to our inventory now. They all do different things, so this one we can eat it, and it will give us some health, energy, or mood, which it does. But if we click this one here, we can click this one, and it says start a fire, which it spawned a little fire particle effect right at our feet here. So that's what it is we're going to try and create here together. There's a little bit more to it than that as well. If I hit escape, we're going to set the system up so that these pickups can be modified directly inside of the details panel over here. So we've selected a pickup and we can define how much health, energy, or mood the pickup gives us, the thumbnail associated with it, the text, the static mesh. We can change that all right here inside of the details panel just to make creating additional pickups a lot easier for us down the road. So I did want to mention that we are using Unreal Engine version 4.8. And that this series is aimed at the beginner to intermediate user of Unreal Engine 4, specifically with blueprints and Unreal Motion graphics, as that's what we're primarily going to be focused on in this video series. So before we continue, I have a quick PowerPoint that I wanted to bring up to kind of cover the different things that we're going to touch on in this video series, and I promise it's the only one that we're going to do. So I'm going to pop that up, and as you can see, we have a lot of things that we're going to cover, so I wanted to touch on them really quickly to kind of identify what each of these entail. So first up, what we're going to do is import some assets. So these are going to be the thumbnails that appear in our inventory. We're going to have to create those externally and import them into the engine so that we can use those to represent our items inside of our inventory. We're also going to create some additional assets inside of the editor, so some additional blueprints for UMG purposes and for our pickups, etc. And then we're going to modify some of the assets that come with the template that we're going to be starting out with as well. So once we get all of that done, then we're going to jump into a quick introduction of Unreal Motion Graphics, or UMG for short, just to make sure that we're all on the same page and have a general understanding of all the different bells and whistles of Unreal Motion Graphics and how you can navigate your way around the interface and how everything works together. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Once we do that, we can begin working with Unreal Motion Graphics to create our player condition setup. So our health, energy, and mood, and displaying that on screen. It's at that point that we're going to start getting into the process of passing information between different blueprints. And how do we do that? How do we communicate from our player character that our player character has lost health? How do we update our HUD? How do we pass that information across? So that's going to be handled in the player condition setup. Once we finish that, we'll begin setting up the visual layout of our inventory menu inside UMG. And this is going to be a little bit more of an intermediate topic. So we've got our foundation out of the way with the introduction and done a little bit in UMG. But when we set up our inventory menu, we're going to deep dive into some of the details such as anchors, working with anchors, how to anchor your UI widgets to various positions on screen and have them maintain that position on various screen sizes. So we're going to talk about anchors a little bit. We're then going to get into stylizing buttons and playing with some of the different properties inside of the designer tab of UMG. And once we set up our inventory menu, then we can begin scripting the UI functionality for our inventory system. So how does the inventory system actually function? We have the visual layout, but what happens when I pick up an item? How are my thumbnails refreshed? How do I bring up that context menu so that I can use or drop items, et cetera? We're gonna do that all on the graph tab inside of UMG. And then once we finish that, we'll actually need to create some pickups that we can pick up. And when we are doing our pickups, we're going to be doing a lot of blueprint work here. So a lot of blueprint visual scripting and specifically communicating between several different blueprints. So our pickups need to communicate not only to our HUD and our inventory system that the item has been picked up, but also to our player character blueprint, because we're gonna affect the player character when we use that item. So we'll be taking a look at blueprint interfaces, event dispatchers, direct blueprint communication, and the number of different ways, as well as casting, the number of different ways that you can communicate between different blueprints and pass information between them. And then once we do that, we'll need to provide a way for the player character to actually bring up the inventory menu or toggle it on and off, as well as pick up and drop items. So we'll set that up inside of the player input, instead of the player character blueprint, we'll set that up. And then finally, we'll finish up by adding some animation to our inventory menu so that it slides in and off screen for us. So it'll be a quick introduction to the animation sequencer inside of UMG. We're not going to go too deep into that, but we'll show you how to set it up and get started with it so that you can start experimenting with it. And then we'll also start taking a look at how we can customize the pickup that we start out with. So we're going to start out with one pickup, and then we're going to modify that so that we can easily create custom pickups based off of a template pickup. So we have a lot to cover. We're going to try to keep these videos between 20 to 25 minutes each. There should not be that many steps in this video series, but we're going to try to aim for a 20 to 25 minute length per video. But the ultimate end goal is to get all the way back to here where we can have a fully functional health, energy, and mood, player condition status, being able to pick up different items in our level, have them all appear in our inventory with their correct thumbnails to which we can either use or drop them, etc. So that is the goal. We are going to pause here. That's going to do it for this video. In the next video, we will get started creating those assets, importing the thumbnail images that we're going to need to create externally, and doing our heavy prep work so we get most of it out of the way so that we can focus on creating the systems in the later videos. So thank you guys for watching, and we will see you in the next video.